seeing my son like this, it was unexpected because I didn't receive a phone call or anything from anyone.
Tonight, an 8-year-old boy is recovering from an allergic reaction to a wasp attack. His mother says he was stung in the face while at school.
But the staff never even called to notify her. Instead, they just sent the boy home on the bus. NBC2's Alex Howard spoke with that mother today.
Well, Shannon Holland couldn't believe it when her third grader was dropped off on the bus, his lip swollen so large. At first, she thought he had gotten into a fight. Now she's looking for answers about how she wasn't notified.
About 5 times the size it should have been.
When the school bus dropped off Shannon Holland's son, Josue, on Thursday, the boy was hiding his face.
He had his shirt over his nose, and I thought maybe he was bleeding.
Then he showed her.
I called 911 because I did not know, you know, because his face was continuing to swell. So I called 911 just to make sure that he was okay.
At first, she and her other children thought the worst.
Whenever he pulled his shirt down, I was like, oh my God, what happened? And you know, my older kids, they're middle school, so they say, oh, he got in a fight or somebody hit him.
But after asking Josue what happened, she realized the mistake.
I was getting my name tag and a wasp came and stung me.
That sting, which had happened towards the end of the school day, was enough for staff to send Josue to the office for help. But they missed one key detail.
Seeing my son like this, it was unexpected because I didn't receive a phone call or anything.
Making for a nightmare scenario for any parent fearing the worst.
They should at least call me and sent him with some ice or something because, I mean, what if he would have stopped breathing on the bus ride home or...
And today, the superintendent of the Hendry County School District told NBC2 the LaBelle Elementary School violated the policy by not calling Shannon. He says they're making changes going forward. Live in studio, Alex Howard, NBC2.
As the U-